My new book is When Good Hair Goes Bad, and it is full of tips and tricks to restore your hair to its former glory. You know, it's for anybody that has found their way along their natural hair journey and they've run into snafus just in the name of versatility, wanting to switch it up, wanting to change their hairstyle, blow it out, try color. And unfortunately, those decisions come with consequences sometimes. So there's short-term solutions and long-term solutions contained in this book to help you get back on the path to refortifying, regrowing, and reclaiming your natural dopeness. My favorite tip is for women that believe that protective styles is like the be-all, end-all in retaining length. It can be if you do it the right way. So in the book, I give tips and tricks for how to protective style your hair depending upon your texture and your scalp needs. Like, you can't rock big, huge, fat, glorious extensions if you have very fine hair like myself, because you will lose your edges. I like to do is slick like a little bit of water on my hands, put on my edges, a little shea butter, a natural oil or a natural butter, apply that to your edges, tie on a scarf and leave it on for like 20 minutes. And when you take it off, edges are laid and they're soft. Like, if you're a bun girl or a ponytail girl, just move it around. You know, high bun on Monday, low bun on Tuesday. If you're putting your bun in the same place every day, you're gonna get breakage either right around the ponytail holder or in your edges. Humidity. So you have to decide if you wanna fight humidity, which I do not recommend. You're gonna need silicone-based products. So you have to get past your fear of silicones. There's lots of science that has gone into this. There's some silicones that do not build up. On CurlyNikki.com and in the book, When Good Hair Goes Bad, we list some ingredients that don't build up that protect your hair from humidity. But nothing will protect your hair 100%. Like, your hair is porous, so it's going to absorb some moisture from the air. But something that you can do is focus on hydrolyzed protein conditioners. Those will actually patch up the holes in your hair that that have incurred like over time from damage from over manipulation. And it will help keep moisture in and lock out atmospheric moisture. Oils for hair growth. So my idea is that it is actually the technique. If you do scalp massages regularly, no matter what oil you use, you're gonna actually be stimulating blood flow and you're gonna see hair growth, no matter the oil. Peppermint oil, like mixed into like coconut or olive oil or something, a lot of folks find, you know, success with that. Amla oil, people have success with that. But again, I think the technique of frequent scalp massages, also cardio, people find that just the idea, if you get the blood moving, get it flowing to your head, that's gonna grow your hair too. Anything that stimulates the scalp and cardio, you get both. My advice for women that are just starting would be to figure out what works for your hair first. It's great, you know, to go out there and you find natural hair YouTubers and bloggers that inspire you. That's absolutely essential. But you cannot expect your hair to look like theirs. You know, like, you manage your expectations. That way you don't run into the frustration, you know, of trying to like mimic something. You know, you have to love yourself, love your own hair, and then you can begin playing around with different styles. All right, ladies, so you can get my book When Good Hair Goes Bad at darkandlovely.com/Nikki Walton, and that's Nikki with two K's. I am Nikki Walton, and this has been your Grio Check-In.